In this tutorial, we will be showing how you can make use of hash variables in your application design. We will be doing it over the sample app, the HR expenses claim app that you can find in your Joget installation as well as from the Joget marketplace. We will be using the current user hash variable as the example in this tutorial. This is the app designer console for HR expenses claim app. We are going to inspect the new claim form to show you how we can make use of hash variables in a form. In this submitted by text field, we can see that it has its value pre-populated by the current user hash variable. By filling up the value in the value attribute, we can define the default value for the target form element. In this case, we are pre-populating this field with the current logged in user's first and last name. By pressing Ctrl hash, we can call up the autocomplete to assist us in looking up the correct hash variable. Once you have found the hash variable that you want, simply hit the Enter key to fill it up. Since we are pre-populating this field, we can check the read-only attribute. Preview the form to see it in action. Next, we are going to show you how we can filter a list by using the current user hash variable. Create a new data list. Name it as current user expense claim list. We can base it on the existing expense claim list. Preview to see the current listing. We are going to change the list now to only show records of the current logged in user. Let's obtain the ID of the field that we are going to filter. Go to Source. Look for extra filter condition under the binder. Key in the following expression. Preview again. The list is now filtered using the current user's information. In this case, the admins. That's all. We hope that you are now able to make use of hash variables to enhance your app design now. Thank you for watching.